Hello everybody, it's Tim Spector of the ZOE COVID Symptom Study app giving you this week's update. And as usual, there's good news and bad news. As I predicted last week, we have seen a peak overall nationally and in London, and cases are starting to come down. And this is true all across the country, except perhaps in the northwest of England. And the R value is close to one, which is good news. But we're not there yet, because that still means there's 57,000 new cases every day and 830,000 people going around with symptomatic infections. That hasn't changed much recently. So while the current wave seems to be on its way out, we're still stuck with big problems in the hospitals, and it takes many weeks for this to carry through to them. And we're seeing really bad rates of 20 to 53% of all patients being COVID related. And that's causing a huge strain on hospitals, particularly in London, where the staff are working incredibly hard to cope with it all. And that's likely to continue for a couple of weeks, even if these new cases do decrease. I was worried last week about the rise in the over 60s, but that looks like it's flattening out across the country, which again is encouraging. So we do need to be vigilant in the next few weeks. Vaccines are going to be increasingly important, and really important that you log getting your vaccine with us through the ZOE app. And if you know anyone who's getting a vaccine, please encourage them to go and download our app and tell us all about it, because we need to know how quickly people are being protected and what kind of adverse problems they might be getting because of the vaccine. Now, while we're waiting at home in lockdown and rates are slowly falling, there are some other things you can do positively. And one is obviously to think for yourself and tell others about all the symptoms of COVID. For some reason, we're still stuck with these three or four classic symptoms in this country. We know they're over 20. And many people are reporting to us that the first signs of COVID are severe fatigue, headache, sore throat, muscle pains, none of which will get you a test. So do assume that you've probably got COVID if you've got those symptoms, and stay away from other people for several days while you do try and get a test, which hopefully should be possible. The other thing you can do is look after your own health, as well as exercise. A few tips about gut health: getting your microbes in order is definitely important. There have been some studies in the news this week showing that your microbiome is, these are the community of gut microbes, are adversely affected by COVID, and that certainly doesn't help the people in hospital. And it's likely that if you keep them in good shape, you can do something to ameliorate the disease. So keep eating fresh plants and vegetables, as diverse as possible. Have some fermented foods and enjoy a bit of high polyphenol foods, like a treat like peanuts, berries, and even dark chocolate and a bit of red wine. Vitamin D has been in the news as well. Our big survey of 2 million people showed that it was a very limited use generally. The only people that seemed to benefit were some women, where we got about less than a 10% reduction in COVID, but that might still be worth it, particularly in the winter months when we're not getting much through sunshine. So that's it for now. Stay as safe as you can and look after yourself and others. Keep logging. Thanks for your support.